Now, if you're worried the social media platforms you use are tracing your every step, well, you're on to something. New research from Massey University shows young people buying and selling drugs undercover on apps like Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat could find it affects their job prospects in the future. Digital trace tools are now able to track online behaviour no matter how small the scale. Public health researcher and report co-writer Robin van der Sanden joins us to discuss. Morning, Robin.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for your time this morning. I was saying to my colleagues moments before this interview, why was this research conducted in the first place?
Well, you know, it was funded, so yeah, you know, you go where the money is.
Well, yeah, but it's incredibly interesting because here we are and we're talking, you know, a small scale, and we're talking about selling drugs on social media platforms. So how common is it for young people to be doing this?
It's pretty common. I mean, and you see that globally, so not just in New Zealand. So back in 2020, the data that we have showed it was around sort of 22% of the sample that we had used social media to buy and sell in the past 6 months. And we'd expect that to kind of keep tracking upwards by a few percentage points each year, with young people much more likely to be the ones to be using social media for this purpose.
Yeah, well, and it kind of makes sense, right? It's one way to be able to get to anybody, anytime, and anywhere. So the people that you spoke to about this research, did they believe that they were flying under the radar? Like, what were some of the questions you asked?
I mean, well, we asked a broad range of questions, and I mean, as part of that, we sort of looked at, you know, like, we thought, okay, do you think you're, you know, secure? Do you worry about police? Do you worry about your data, you know, being used at all to catch you? And I mean, look, a lot of these people, because they're so peripherally involved, you know, the risk of being caught by law enforcement is viewed as low. But at the same time, a lot of them are very aware, like, look, I don't want a criminal record because I know that really disadvantages me in life. But at the same time, you know, a lot of them kind of were quite nonchalant about receiving targeted ads for drug-related stuff, you know, which kind of, you know, and they were quite aware of the fact that Facebook has, well, Meta has probably identified them as a drug user, but it sort of didn't connect the dots, really, that that could flow on into other areas of their lives.
Wow. And I imagine that after the research, potentially they might have started thinking about that, to be perfectly honest.
Maybe I did maybe help a few people out, I'm not going to lie.
So, you know, I mean, you've got the study. You asked a number of people about, you know, what they were doing online. Is there potential for this, just like you did, in educating people?
I mean, I think definitely there is space to maybe help young people, especially, become maybe more aware of some of the privacy risks of using social media for drugs. But it's also, you know, when it comes to kind of all the digital trace data that they're collecting, it's sort of, you know, you can't really escape it in this day and age. So it's kind of more about thinking about how we can regulate the companies that are doing the collecting and that are kind of using the data.
You know, I guess as a young person, you're only thinking about the here and now, and you're not thinking about the long-term impacts of your actions. So, you know, and I know that you specifically spoke to the participants around long-term effects. What were the answers there?
Well, look, I mean, there's kind of this, like, resignation to the fact that, you know, your data is kind of out there. And for all of us, you know, not just for young people buying and selling drugs, you know, this data is likely to come back and kind of haunt us in our later lives. So there's kind of this resignation of like, well, I can't really do anything about that.
We really appreciate your time this morning. Robin van der Sanden, who is the public health researcher behind this paper in particular.
Thank you so much for having me.
So good. Thank you. Gosh, it's really interesting, eh? Because then we know, you know, you've got your big social media platforms, Meta, who are actually taking all of this information. And again, some of these participants were getting ads that were about drugs. But yet that still wasn't a red flag for them to go, maybe Meta's collecting my information and my data and targeting me with the kinds of advertisements that I'm receiving. Really interesting.
Yeah, anyway. Wouldn't have thought that's the best place to be conducting your nefarious business, would it?
Well, yes, on one hand, but on another hand, as I said earlier, this is a platform where you can reach anybody at any time.